Hey everyone, and welcome to the third video in a series covering Excel tips and tools every engineer should know. Today I'll be talking about the Pareto chart, which is a great tool for breaking down complex problems and identifying the key inputs or causes to those problems. This is a great tool for prioritizing issues when you aren't sure what to focus on. Now it's pretty straightforward, so let's dive in. Say we're given the task of reducing our company's cost of defects, which sounds like a great cause. Companies love to have more money in their pocket. So if your boss asked you to do something like this, your first thought would probably be, where do I begin? Saying reduce the defect cost for the entire company is a complex problem, and it has many causes or things driving those defect costs. So luckily we have some data here to help us out, as well as a tool called a Pareto analysis or a Pareto chart, which will help us figure this out. Pareto analysis is based on the Pareto principle, which says that 20% of causes are responsible for 80% of defects. Another way to think about this is that 20% of inputs are responsible for 80% of outputs. Now, a good example, just to kind of put this in perspective, is that for many companies, 80% of their sales might only come from 20% of their products or 20% of their customers or something like that. Analyzing data in this way helps us find the vital few causes responsible for the effect in question. The effect in our case is the defect cost or the defects for our company. And so if we make a Pareto chart of this, hopefully we can find the vital few causes driving that defect cost. So our data here is showing us three different categories for each month and then the cost associated with it. So we have three different defect categories, scrap, rework, and obsolescence. So if we wanted to know which one of these three was the biggest driver for our defect cost, we could make a Pareto chart of this. And we just grab those two columns and insert a Pareto chart. Excel, as of 2017, has a Pareto chart built right in. So you can just select that and it creates that for us, which is super handy. So we can see this is the total for an entire year. And we can see right away, just very easily visually, that scrap is our biggest driver of defect cost within our company. We can see that roughly, I don't know, 60% or so comes from scrap, about 35% might come from rework, and 10-15% comes from obsolescence. That math didn't really add up, but again, just great visual here to be able to see that we have this one main effect, or main cause, causing our effect. So the cool thing about Pareto charts here is now that we understand that scrap is our biggest defect category, we can dive in and say, well, what are the causes of scrap? So scrap in this case is going to be material or product that is defective and was thrown out, basically. So we have some scrap data here, and this is basically going to be order information. If you have an ERP system or something like that, it's pretty easy to get information like this. Most have it. So we have an order number, a part number, the date that the transaction occurred, the scrap code, the shift that it happened on, and then the operator that actually scrapped the units. So you can see right off the bat, we have a lot of different categories that we can look at and begin to understand what are our key drivers causing our scrap. So I already have an example here, and this is looking at scrap by part number. So we can see that this particular part number has the most units scrapped, and then it kind of trails off from there. So it's just a great visual to say, all right, we know exactly which part number to focus on, because say we were to reduce this by 50%, and we reduce the scrap on this part number by 50%, well, that 50% is a lot larger and will have a lot greater impact than if we were to reduce the scrap on this part number, just as an example. So let's do another example of that. If I want to look at scrap code, I can just grab all the columns here all the way over to the units scrapped and then insert another Pareto chart. And we can see scrap by scrap code. So now we know what are the main causes to scrap. And we can see right away, burrs are the number one cause of scrap. Setup pieces would be the second most, then tool marks, and so on down the line. Again, this gives us what priority or what thing we should focus on. So let's do one more as an example, and we'll look at it by operator. Insert another Pareto chart. And now we have scrap by operator. And we can see that operator A is the biggest culprit causing scrap. So we can see that we broke down a complex problem down to more digestible parts, and it gives us three really good avenues to investigate and to look at improving, rather than just saying, all right, well, I'm going to start with this random part number and I'm going to try to improve it. Well, is that the thing we should be focusing on? We don't know until we look at it in this manner. So we have three really great avenues. We can look at this part number in particular and say, how can we reduce the scrap of this particular part number? We can look and say, how do we reduce burrs within our processes? And we can say, all right, maybe this particular operator needs some more training, and look at things that way. So we have three really good avenues on how to, again, look at reducing defect costs. So these effects, or these causes, drive all the way back to this effect. So hopefully from this video, you now know how to use Excel's Pareto chart feature to break down complex problems to identify the vital few inputs that drive an issue. Let me know in the comments below if you have any cool examples of how you use Pareto charts to solve complex problems. And if you're new to using Pareto charts, let me know how you plan to incorporate them into your engineering toolbox. Thanks for watching.